Welcome all. In this lecture, we are discussing the topic starters for induction motor. So first we can explain why starters are needed in induction motor. So consider the equivalent circuit of an induction motor. And if you are considering here, this R dash is depending upon the slip. So under starting condition, when the motor tend to start, the rotor is at rest condition, it is at stationary, standstill condition, means NR, the speed of rotor is zero under starting condition. So when NR is zero, slip will be equal to NS minus 0 by NS, so slip is 1. So under starting condition, slip is 1, then R dash become 0. So R dash 0 means this become a short circuit. So here this condition is similar to the condition of block rotor test, but the current will be more, the condition is more worse than the block rotor test. Okay, in block rotor test we were applying only a reduced voltage, but here we are applying the rated voltage to start the motor. Okay, so the current will be ISN, the short circuit current corresponding to normal voltage or rated voltage. So this current will be very high. So a large starting current equal to ISN is drawn by the motor at the time of starting. It will be very large, say approximately or about 5 to 7 times that of rated current. Okay. So for small power rated motor, this is not a problem. But for higher power rated motor, this is undesirable. Okay. So it will cause many disturbance to the supply. So that's why we are using starters to reduce this starting current. Okay. So first we can discuss direct online starter. So as the name suggests, here we are directly turning on the supply to the motor. There is no provision to reduce the starting current. Okay. So we are directly turning on supply to the motor. If this contact is closed, the supply will be fed to the motor. Okay. So in practical condition, we are not directly turning or directly making this contacts on. We are using a solenoidal based control circuit. Okay. So here we are actuating this solenoid using this supply. Okay. Through this connection. Okay. So this stop button is NC, normally closed position. Okay. And the start button is normally open. Okay, so this will be closed. So only this start button depends the connection to this solenoid. Okay. So initially this is open circuit, so there is no attractive force to the solenoid. This M will be in open position. Okay. So when we are pressing this start button, this become closed, connection become closed, and there will be a current through this solenoid, and this solenoid will actuate, and this contacts will be attracted to this one, and this will be closed. Okay, so contacts will be closed and motor start to run. But when we are releasing this button, the connection to the solenoid is disconnected, hence the motor get turned off. Okay, the motor will stop. So we have to make sure that the force to the connection to this solenoid should remain even though this button is released. So we are using an additional auxiliary contact. So when we are pressing this, this will actuate and this contact will close. Okay. So now even though start button is released, the connection will be remain connected through this. Okay, through this circuit. Okay. So even though start button is released, it will continue to rotate, motor will continue to rotate. Okay, since the actuation is remaining. Okay. And when we want to stop the motor, we can press this stop button, so it become open, and this supply, this connection to the solenoid will disconnected, and this actuator will be released, and this contacts will turn off. Okay, remains off, and the motor will stop. And in addition to this, we are giving a overload protection. overload protection relay like this. Okay, so under normal current this solenoid will not be acting. Okay, this will not be acting. So if the current through this solenoid is very high, or the if a overcurrent occur, there will be a large current. Okay, so under this current, this will come to action, and this solenoid will give a force such that this contact is moved away. Okay, means the if this is contact is moved away, this become open, the control circuit become open, and the main solenoid become deactivated, and this main contact will be released. Okay, so the under load, under an abnormal condition, a large current will be taken by the motor, and so under this condition this will be actuating and the control circuit will be disconnected. So hence the motor, this main contact will be released and motor become stopped. Okay, so in this way we are providing a overcurrent protection in this direct on a starter. But here we are not reducing the starting current. There is no method for reducing the starting current. Okay, so we can analyze the starting torque. Okay, so we know that the slip is given by rotor copper loss by air gap power, or we can say that air gap power is equal to rotor copper loss by S. Again, we can write the rotor copper loss 3 I2 dash square into R2 dash, where R2 is the resistance of rotor winding. So if we obtain PG, we can find the torque developed by PG by 2 pi NS by 60, where NS is the synchronous speed. Okay, so PG is this 3 I2 dash square R2 dash by S. So this will be, so we can write that this torque is proportional to I2 square by S, or I2 is proportional to the supply current. So we can say that torque developed is proportional to IS square by S. Okay, then under full load condition, this we can find the full load torque TFL, TD become TFL, and IS become the full load current, the rated current, S become the S full load. Okay, slip corresponding to full load. So we can say that the full load torque will be proportional to full load current square divided by slip. And under starting condition, TD equal to the starting torque, IS become the starting current, and slip is 1. Under starting condition, slip is 1. So we can say that the starting torque is directly proportional to the square of starting current. From these two equations, we can find the ratio of starting torque to the full load current like this. Okay, so we found the ratio. And in case of DOL starter, starting current is ISN. That is, we told that there is no reduction in the current, or we are not reducing any current. There is no method to reduce the starting current. It is the ISN itself. Okay, the short circuit current corresponding to rated voltage ISN. So the ratio TST by TFL is equal to ISN by IFL whole square into SFL, or we can find the TST in terms of TFL. Okay, so there will be a large starting torque required at the time of starting. Also, the line current, so this ISN is actually the phase current. Okay, so the line current drawn from the supply will be the line value of this ISNL. Okay, so this current will be drawn from the supply. So ISNL we can find according to the motor connection. Okay, if it is star, it is same as the phase, or if it is delta, it is root 3 times of ISN. So anyway, the ISNL, the short circuit current corresponding to normal voltage will be drawn from the supply under starting current. Hence, the DOL starter is not protecting there is no provision to reduce the starting current. So it can be only used for the small power rated motor. Say we can use it up to 2.2 kilowatt. Above that, we cannot use this method. Okay, so another starter is auto transformer starter. Okay, so in this starter, we are using a auto transformer to make the voltage applied to the motor a reduced voltage. Okay, we are applying a reduced voltage to the motor. We are connecting the motor in the secondary of the auto transformer. So we will be applying the rated voltage in the primary, and the secondary voltage will be applied to the motor. Okay. And the applied voltage will be the secondary voltage. Okay. Then it is a reduced voltage. There will be reduction. Okay. Then the phase current taken by the motor will be ISN into V secondary divided by V rated. Under V rated, the current will be ISN. Okay. If you are giving a rated voltage directly to the motor, the current taken will be ISN. Okay. So if the voltage is reduced, it will be V reduced, V secondary divided by V rated. Okay. But we know that if the transformer ratio is K, okay, the V secondary will be K times V primary, means V secondary is equal to K into V rated. Okay. So ISN equal to IST is equal to ISN into K V rated divided by V rated. So we will get the phase current taken by the motor at the time of starting is K ISN. Okay, it will be reduced K times. Okay, K will be less than 1. Since it is auto transformer, the voltage across the secondary will be less than that of the primary. Okay. It will be less than 1. So thus we can reduce the starting current. So anyway, this is actually the phase current of the motor. Okay. So the line current will be this IML. Okay. So IML will be the line value of ISNL. Okay. ISN. Okay. It is ISNL. The line value of the short circuit current under normal voltage. Okay. So the line current will be equal to K ISNL, where ISNL is the line current, short circuit current corresponding to normal voltage. So again, will be depending upon the motor connection. Anyway, we'll get the line current taken by the motor. So here, this is the line current. So if you are looking here, this line current is same as I secondary, okay, secondary current. Okay, so we can say that I secondary is equal to K ISNL. Okay. Then if we have the secondary current, we can find the primary current. So if the line current line current taken from supply will be the primary current. Okay, this is the primary current. It is actually the current taken by the motor at the starting. Okay, ILS is I primary, but I primary is K into I secondary. Okay, K is the transformation ratio. Okay, so we can say the ILS will be equal to K into I secondary, but I secondary is K ISNL, so it is K into ISNL, so it becomes K square ISNL. Okay, means the starting current is reduced by K square times. K will be less than 1. Okay, the transformation ratio is less than 1. Okay. So we can say that the starting line current, the line current will be reduced K square times when we are using a auto transformer starter. Okay. Again, we can analyze the starting torque when we are starting with auto transformer starter. Okay. So we have this equation, TST by TFL is equal to IST by IFL whole square into SFL. Okay. So if you are using the auto transformer starter, IST is equal to K times ISN. Okay, so if you are substituting here, it will be this. Okay, so we can say that TST is K square into TFL into ISN by IFL whole square into SFL. So the starting torque is also reduced by K square times. Okay. So this is the schematic diagram of a auto transformer starter. Okay, at the starting time we are using a auto transformer. Okay, and running time we are directly connecting the motor to the supply. Okay, so at the starting time this contacts will be kept this position. Okay, so the motor will be getting a voltage through the auto transformer winding. Okay, a reduced voltage like this all through all phases. Okay, this R phase will be connected like this. Okay, so only this much voltage will be apply to the motor. Okay, K times the after transformation ratio, and after starting, if the speed is attained a normal, there is no problem of high starting is the starting current. So we are keeping this contact to run position. So if it is at run position, means the supply will be connected to this point and directly to this, so the motor will be connected with the rated voltage. So with this, we can wind up the session. Thank you.